Francisco in France. Hello, coaches. Concerning natural gas, we have bull trend, implied premium, so good setup. Thinking incrementalist, should I wait for a low range price, or is this particular asset, can I add incrementally with the current setup? Thanks.
You can, if you don't want to wait for the low end of the range, you can do whatever you want, right? I buy it when it's down, I'd sell it when it's up. You know, if you want to buy, set up your rules too, right? If you want to, you know, some people want it to be perfect, and I have to be perfect in real-time alerts or people will complain, right? So again, it is what it is. So if you have your back to your longs versus your shorts, we have a 6% position, if that's what you're trying to get to, you know, maybe you start to, like, when it's down, you only add 15 or 25 beeps, right? 15, 0.15 to 0.25%, right? If I'm at a 2% position, this question is born out of one very basic reality. People just don't buy enough when they should, all right? So that's a fact. And then you're like, oh, now it's correcting, and I didn't, like, you had all day, every day to buy energy, for example, for multiple weeks, right? But and then it moves a bunch, and then you're like, oh, I gotta buy more. That is not how to do this. That's how I used to do it. It's how a lot of people still do it. It's called emotions. It's called feelings. We all have those things, right? But if you just wanna add 15 to 25 basis points, you just put that in your calculator. When you build a portfolio, do not look at the dollars in the portfolio. Look at as the percentage of your capital at risk, okay? So if I'm at 2%, I wanna get to, you know, again, if it's down today, I hit the button on this, I've already got a calculator on my total capital. I don't have to sit there every day and like hand bomb it, like, oh, I'm gonna buy 25 basis points of this. No. And if you're a sophisticated hedge fund, obviously every single order that you put in is pre-programmed against the total capital in your account. So then you just take, like, I took this out of my mind like in 2001 when I started like not thinking about total dollars. Think about it. I'm from Thunder Bay, Ontario, and I'm running hundreds of millions of dollars at a time all of a sudden. Think about like what would happen to my mind if I knew how many bucks or millions I could lose in a day and would, right? So I stopped that. So again, start thinking about it in terms of percentage of your capital, and then you're gonna do things with much more discipline. It's a lot more about the discipline in your life and in your portfolio management than anything else. You gotta do things the same way. You know, you gotta put in, unless you're magical, you gotta put on one shoe at a time, one skate at a time. You gotta take one step at a time. Things have to be incremental, okay? So again, if you missed it, you missed it. Let's fix that problem to start. When it's down here 2% and you're at the low end of the range, why not 50 basis points at a time, 100 basis points at a time? That's exactly how you should think about it, right? So step it up, step it down. I definitely step it down when we're just coming off the top end of the range. So when you look at energy and basic materials and financials, you know, if you want to step up 100 basis points at a time because you missed the move, you got to go back and really recalibrate why you missed the move and understand that before you start to make the second mistake, which is going big after the move.